Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to 6G Flagship YouTube channel. My name is Matti Latva-aho. I'm director for 6G Flagship, operated at the University of Oulu. We started our flagship research program already back in 2018, so we had a head start in starting 6G research globally. We are now living our second phase of the flagship program, which started last May, and will continue to the end of 2028 in order to make sure that we remain relatively active to the final phases of 6G standardization. Our flagship is operated by University of Oulu, and currently we have about 400 researchers from 50 different nationalities which have teamed up to make 6G flagship research team. Some of our research visions are summarized in a series of white papers that we published a couple of years ago, 13 of those, which became rather popular globally and showing our views on relevant research issues and challenges related to 6G research. We have been active in publishing most of our research, which you can find from our publication databases, and our collaboration with industry has been very active from the very beginning of the flagship. If you look back about 20 years ago, when we were starting to develop 4G technology, the vision globally was always best connected to the vision made in 2003, for example, by European Commission. As an end result, we are enjoying today various applications that we can use with our smartphone type of devices. When 5G was being developed, we were envisioning the next tens of billions of connected things wirelessly to the internet. We were talking about Internet of Things era. Currently, there are various levels of consumer products that are based on this vision. Now that we have been thinking about what is the major breakthrough with 6G era, maybe two things that can be addressed at this stage of research. Massive digital twinning and later on 6G metaverse will probably be the groundbreaking new types of applications built around future wireless technologies, changing our professional lives, our personal lives, and also entertainment systems in various forms. So overall, I think we are moving towards holistic digitalization of society. All will be connected, and we depend more and more on these digital models or replicas of real processes, machines, even about the humans in the future. We have several critical drivers that are pushing us in 6G Flagship forward in our daily research. These are not in any sort of order, but if I start from these United Nations Sustainability Development Goals and digitalization, massive digitalization of societies, we really need to have global coverage, global connectivity in order to carry on using the services no matter where we are and what type of services we are interested in using. Also, it is important to make sure that developing countries and remote locations are part of future digital societies. Various different new types of verticals are emerging right at the moment, from industry to healthcare, agriculture, retail, logistics, you name it. All these verticals have their own ecosystems, they have their own application needs, and most importantly, they have their own requirements for communication system performance. This development will partially disrupt current mobile network operator-centric business models, and it will also require some regulatory changes making this type of development possible. Global collaboration today is probably more important than ever before due to a very difficult geopolitical situation. As we know, there's a new standard introduced for mobile communications every 10 years. The next one, 6G, is estimated to be on the markets 2030. Business is reshaped much shorter pace, and new ecosystems are in place in much slower pace, like 20-year cycles. So we have to understand that 5G and 6G together will enable this change towards something new, the next era. Spectrum regulation principles are changing even much slower pace, and some of the developments that we see necessary for the future are related exactly on spectrum regulation. If this pervasive, holistic digitalization of societies is really happening and these new services are part of our daily lives no matter what we do, then the data privacy and security issues are becoming more important than ever before. It's important to understand what does it mean from different stakeholder perspectives. What do we own ourselves as individual consumers? What can be shared with others? What is needed for efficient society daily operation? Network architectures probably will be evolving towards service centricity rather than radio access network centric thinking that is dominant today. In the end of the day, the consumers and end user applications, they don't really care what wireless connectivity solutions are utilized whilst carrying different services to the end users. One of the new things that have started to emerge with 5G already is the new development towards super efficient local connectivity solutions. This efficiency can mean extreme speeds, extreme reliability, low latency, maybe very accurate localization or sensing accuracy, which are possible and have become very interesting when we are talking about utilization of higher spectrum bands, even above 100 gigahertz. These can be achieved only locally. That is very clear and not possible in macro scale. Recent years have shown us enormous leap in deploying artificial intelligence to different applications. Artificial intelligence has also become very important in networks, automated optimization, even in the wildest visions, designing the overall radio access network physical layer. These and many other issues will be explored in much more detail with our 6G Talks webinar series. Here are some tentative topics that we have been drafting to be presented to you in the coming months, even next year, some of these, and will be presented by our numerous researchers as well as invited leading experts around the world, as well as some of the dominant industrial players in the field. So stay tuned and follow us in our various social media channels.